This is a podcast from the Nuffield Department of Medicine. Dr. George Warimwe talks about his research on Rift Valley fever. Hello, George.
Hi.
What is Rift Valley fever?
So Rift Valley fever is a disease that of livestock. It is transmitted by mosquitoes and caused by a virus called the Rift Valley fever virus. It primarily infects sheep, goats, and cattle, although the disease also affects humans, so it is a zoonosis. In sheep, which is the species that bears the brunt of the disease, you get very high mortalities in young lambs, and in pregnant sheep, you get abortions, which is a hallmark of the disease. In humans, you get a febrile illness that tends to resemble something like flu. Although a proportion of individuals do get severe complications such as blindness or even death.
Is it widespread, and do we have a vaccine?
So the virus was originally isolated in Kenya in 1930, and since then there's been a spread of the disease throughout much of Africa, and much of Africa now is actually has the disease, so it is endemic in Africa. Although in the last decade the disease has popped up in the Middle East, parts of the Middle East, and there are growing concerns that the virus will spread to Europe and other parts of the world, particularly because the mosquitoes that transmit the virus are widespread globally. So that is, of course, a worry. But we do not have a vaccine, which is, again, adds to the worry, and that is why there are many programs trying to develop a vaccine against Rift Valley fever.
Mm. Can you tell us about your work with the International Livestock Research Institute?
So the International Livestock Research Institute, which I'll call ILRI, is a center of excellence in Africa. So they develop disease control interventions against diseases that are most prevalent in Africa. For instance, East Coast fever and Rift Valley fever, which is one of them. And it is one of very few institutes in Africa that actually have that capacity and expertise of livestock vaccine development. So building on that experience, and together with experience here at the Jenner Institute, I'm going to exploit the synergies between the vaccine development, livestock vaccine development, and human vaccine development, which is done here at the Jenner Institute, to develop a vaccine against Rift Valley fever, which might be useful for both livestock and humans.
And what are the most important lines of research that have developed over the past 5 or 10 years?
So over the last decade, there's been a lot of information coming through about the biology of the virus, and this has been very useful in terms of working out what are the best targets for a vaccine or any other intervention. The other development has been in a better understanding of the epidemiology of the disease, and so now we know more about the risk factors that lead to Rift Valley fever. And one of the really standout points has been that because Rift Valley fever tends to occur as outbreaks that are preceded by unusually heavy rainfall, there's been development of models that can predict when Rift Valley fever will occur, just based on precipitation. So that's really useful as a tool that can be used together with vaccine strategy, vaccination programs and other control strategies, disease control strategies.
So why does your line of research matter? Why should we put money into it?
Well, Rift Valley fever, like a disease like malaria, is a disease that disproportionately affects people in Africa, and in this case, farmers. So it restricts trade because there are trade barriers if the country has got Rift Valley fever endemic. It also has an impact on human health.
And how does your research fit into translational medicine within the department?
A strategic objective of the Jenner Institute is to prioritize vaccine development for pathogens that are widespread in Africa. They are most prevalent in Africa, and this includes things like malaria, HIV, TB, and Rift Valley fever is one that fits such a profile. So the ultimate aim of my work is to develop a vaccine that can be used for humans. However, because the same virus that causes human Rift Valley fever is the one that is the same that causes disease in sheep and other livestock, a vaccine for human use would also be useful, potentially for livestock, which we think is really translational.
Thank you, George.